All right, that's enough. I had to put on the music to bump me up, you know, get me pumped to listen to this. Guys, I'm back. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys enjoy this video today. You already know what it is. I told you about this, guys, a long time ago. I told you when The Weeknd drops an album, listening to the whole thing. I only reacted to, I think, one of his singles a couple months ago in 2021, but 2022, new year, he just dropped this out today. Today is January 7th, and he dropped this at midnight today. And we're going to jump into Don FM. Very, very excited to listen to this. The only thing I've listened to is Take My Breath, and that came out back in August last year. I remember when that came out. I didn't do a video on that, but it's a good song, so we're going to jump into it immediately. Enough talk. You guys know The Weeknd is one of my favorite artists, and I'm excited to listen to this album. After Hours helped me a lot through 2020. So it's 2022. We're still in this pandemic, but we need this. Let's listen to Don FM. Let me jump into it right now.
Way too long. It's time to walk into the light and accept your fate with open arms.
So, Don FM, first track. That was just really like an intro to the album. Nothing special, just kind of like to whet our appetite. On to the second track. Second track, Gasoline. Oh, okay. I already like this. Okay. 80 Cent beat. That's just, I think it's gonna be the whole album. This is Cent. That kinda got dark. Alright, track number two, Gasoline. What do I think of that? That is, it had some kinda like dark subject on it a little bit. Like, it was, I kinda, different take. It sounded like, again, this whole 80s synth pop thing is going on a lot. Ever since he dropped, I want to say Blinding Lights, ever since Blinding Lights came out in 2019, The Weeknd's been on the heavy 80s synth kind of thing. Like, he's been on the 80s style heavy, 70s and 80s thing. It's just been heavy. But what I do like is that he can make a catchy song, an upbeat song, but behind the lyrics are much more deeper, much more sad. When you actually listen to it and kind of think about what he's saying, it's a little bit like sad and more thought-provoking. So, next track, How Do I Make You Love Me? Again, we got some pop beats going on.
We're going back in time.
Okay, I like this. Oh no, don't do that. Don't do that. Oh, transitions. Already, I'm starting to like this album more. Transitions. If you guys don't know, the best thing to me about The Weeknd, what he did on Kissland, you guys see what I have right there, that post. That's my favorite album by The Weeknd. That helped me out. When I first listened to that, 2020, again, when I first listened to that, I got heavy into The Weeknd back then. That album, I was going through a rough time in life, okay? I'm not going to make a long thing of it, but that album helped me out. And the best thing about that album, the transitions on that album, just, After Hours, there's some transitions on that too, but For sure, this, and I already know, the next track must be Take My Breath. So, just by that, it's even 7 seconds left in this song. You can, so, what I think of this, again, we got the pop heavy, but I'm loving the transitions. I don't know about it yet. I don't know about it yet, but let's, next track is Take My Breath, I already know. Look. This is not even Take My Breath yet, but this is the end of, it's about to go home. It's probably gonna be the best album. This is probably gonna be the best song of the album still, probably. I don't know though. It might not. The composition on this, just the composition, man. The composition on this track alone is just. I can just imagine me like in a skating rink, just dancing and just like getting it on the song. If they remixed it. Take My Breath. Hey, how do I feel about that? I already told you guys before the song. That's my favorite song on here so far. Like, it's probably gonna be my favorite song. Just the instrumental, the composition, the melody, everything on that track is like, oh man, this is just. I'm kind of mad that it didn't like. I like that better than Blinding Lights. I don't know how Blinding Lights is a good song, but this to me. Should have got what Blinding Lights did, in my opinion. It should be big, like, it's big. It's just better. A lot of people were complaining. I already saw on Instagram and on Twitter, people were saying this is The Weeknd's worst album. It is definitely different. I wouldn't say it's worse than other stuff. I haven't listened to everything. We're only on track. We're about to be, is that, no. It's technically track number four. The first one is more of an intro track. So it's track number four. We're only on number four out of 16. We got more. Way more. We got 12 more songs. But I would definitely say this is The Weeknd's most, at least composition-wise and so far, only and lyrically right now. I don't know about the rest of it. He's definitely evolved. It's not so dark and depressing like you said. This is just bright and pop. This is just pure pop. So let's jump into the next track. Sacrifice. Ooh, see? Oh! I was born in a city where the winter nights don't ever sleep. This just sounds like an MJ song. My things will never be. Every time you try to fix me. Trying to jump into the next song. We ain't finished talking about this one. This one was Sacrifice. Second favorite song so far. Definitely. Oh, the instrumentals. The instrumentals. Enough said, man. What else can I say? This sounded like an MJ song. Like, just a little bit dark. We know with the lyrics and the subject, but this was a. It sounded like Thriller, like the instrumental a little bit, and then like just with a little extra. It sounded like, I don't know, I almost want to say like a Rick James song and Michael Jackson like combined. It kind of sounded like, I wouldn't say super. It did sound like Rick James and Michael Jackson kind of like, or maybe like Prince, a little bit of Prince kind of too. Like, it sounded similar, but. So far, our second favorite. Let's jump on to A Tale by Quincy. I'm pretty sure this is produced by Quincy. So let's see.
Looking back now, I didn't know what it was supposed to be. And it's like raising kids, man. If you weren't raised, you don't know how to raise, you know? I just did the best thing I could with them because they know well I love them. But I did do the best I could. I will never forget watching my mother get put in a straitjacket and taken out of my home when I was only 7 years old. I had become romantically involved with. Whenever I got too close to the woman, I would cut her off. Part of that was vindictive and partially based on fear. But it was also totally subconscious.
Oh. A Tale by Quincy. That was basically Quincy Jones giving a little bit of... I guess he was talking to them, to Abel, like, telling him, like, about love, basically. He was probably asking him, like, hey, what's your experience on relationships and with your childhood and everything? And he was just giving us a big backstory, and that was interesting. It was like I guess it's the interlude, maybe. Maybe it's too far for interlude, but I don't know. But we're gonna jump into it. Definitely gonna jump into this. The next one is Out of Time. Okay. Can I just say this sounds like, forget the 80s, this is a 70s song right here. This, okay, maybe a little 70s and 80s. You know what it reminds me of, what am I thinking of? Maybe 70s and 80s, this reminded me of, like, Shalimar right now. I don't know if you guys know about Shalimar. Shalimar and, why can't I think? Shalimar, Switch, maybe even, why can't I think of the name? Just now, this reminded me of Shalimar, Switch, the DeBarge family. This sounds just like that.
The last few months I've been working on me, baby. There's so much trauma in my life.
The feels. This one hurts right here. Oh my gosh, the feels on this. Oh. The feels. Oh my gosh. Dang. This is top. This is probably my second favorite now. Oh my gosh. Oh.
Don't you dare touch that dial, because like the songs.
Out of Time. What can I say? Again, okay, so Take My Breath, maybe Out of Time now, then Sacrifice. So far, top three on here. Out of Time was just, I don't know what these EXO fans are talking about. That right there, that is fire. Maybe because I like old school music. That is nothing like Before the Weeknd has ever. That is completely, like, I wouldn't say completely opposite, but it is so, like, soulful and, like, relaxed. It isn't like, okay, I'll give you that. That is nothing like What You Need or even High For This. If you listen to High For This, What You Need, or Coming Down, and you listen to that, you be like, that's the same artist, of course, the voice, but completely stylistically different songs. This is progression, in my opinion. It's progression. This is like, I want more music like this. This reminds me of Soul Sonic. That album was fire. I don't know, okay, we're gonna go to the next track, track number 8, Here We Go Again. We're halfway done. Don FM, and I'll just let you guys know, thoroughly enjoying it. So,
I celebrating Super Bowl. Catalog looking legend.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. This is featuring Tyler the Creator, so Tyler the Creator too.
A quarter bill on and off, yeah. Used to sing on loss, but now we cruising on the yacht. We clear, yeah. Said you wanted your boyfriend, jealous with a couple pills. But here we go again. Ooh.
Oh gosh.
We don't know how it's gonna be forever. It's too long to me. Sign this prenup. You gon' sign this prenup.
Here we go again. Definitely, I enjoyed this. This is. I'm enjoying it. The only track I haven't really liked is Gasoline. That's the only track. I don't think he should have put that as a opening track. That's the only one that hasn't been that great. Let me look back and double check. Gasoline and How Do I Make You Love Me haven't been great, in my opinion. I like Take My Breath, Sacrifice, Out of Time, Here We Go Again. So we got more. So let's listen. The next one is Best Friends.
Best Friends, solid track. Again, it's talking about, I guess maybe,
I think it's talking about whoever the Weeknd, Abel, whatever you want to call him, is with right now. He doesn't want feelings involved. He just wants something casual. That's the best way to say it. Solid track. It was solid. It wasn't as good as Here We Go Again or Out of Time. So, but let's move on to the next track. Is There Someone Else?
Oh,
I heard a little preview of this. Automatically. The transition, bros. The transitions. Oh, what did I say? Is There Someone Else? That was loving this album. Only having like two songs. Loving the album. Loving it. Love it. Even the first two songs, if I listen to it again, I'll probably like them later on. Because I didn't like Escape from L.A. And I was actually listening to that earlier. That joint go hard but at first. But just the opening instrumental with that little talking part. I heard that before. It was like a preview. I was like, oh, that song is going to be... Oh, bro. I need the next one. Okay, next one. And this is a transition. The end of a transition into the next song, Starry Eyes. So... let's jump into it. I only imagine what my dreams were born. When I was young and alone in the world, you were there when I needed someone, something from a shattered soul. Oh, 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 a shattered soul. Let me be there, let me be there for your heart. Let me be there, I can be there until you're home. This is you sad. Background lazy to this. But let me love you, this. Let me love you like you need. Let me love you like you need. Then you can kick me. Starry Eyes, sad, sad song, but I can relate to it. Just talking about he wants to treat this girl right. You know what? I just want to start off by saying The Weeknd has definitely changed even lyrically, because now he's just talking about a lot about relationships. Like, he talked about relationships a little bit in Trilogy era, in House of Balloons, Thursday, and the whole trilogy was about one girl, apparently. And, you know, in his life before he got famous, you know, it was rough. And then he talked about more about the one girl again in Kiss Land. Beauty Behind the Madness, nah, that's about like rock star. And Starboy too. Except for towards the end, it kind of talks about him falling in love again. And then definitely My Dear Melancholy. Whole thing is just about, you know, that one girl, you know, Selena, basically. And then After Hours is about, I think, Bella Hadid. But this is just, he's changed. Because a lot of the times he was just talking about, you know, about being with multiple women. It wasn't just about one. It was a lot about, you know, he would sing a lot about the rock star life. Multiple women, you know, drinking, drugs. It was very like that. But now, it's very just talking about one girl and trying to do right by her. So he's definitely changed a lot. So, next one is Every Angel is Terrifying. That should be interesting. Oh, this must be talking about women. Interesting.
Every angel is terrified.
Provocative, edgy, thought-provoking, technically and visually stunning. A compelling work of science fiction that can be yours for only $4.95 with a subscription when you order the best of your current life collection series.
I don't even count that as a song. That was a troll. That is just like a callback to commercials you saw on TV. This is a TV commercial in the 80s. That's all it was. I don't think it had any type of... All this was a troll. That was a troll track. So, let's listen to Don't Break My Heart. Don't Break My Heart. Oh, we only got 4 freaking songs left on this album. The album has been fire.
Time I know for sure. Just don't break my heart.
Dang. Transitions on that. I know it's gonna be a transition for sure. Good song. I like it. Isn't anything my, it's not my favorite. It's definitely still again better than Gasoline and what was the other one? How Do I Get You to Love Me? How Do I Make You Love Me? Yeah. It's still better than that, but I like the instrumental. I just would have took out that that little tapping. I don't like that. It's been overplayed, but besides that, good. So next one is I Heard You're Married. And this is featuring Lil Wayne, so it'll be interesting. Haven't heard Wayne in a while. I already like the instrument better. Besides Lil Wayne, that was a good song. Good track. I Heard You Married Girl. I mean, I liked it. Just Lil Wayne. I think he ruined it, though. Like, I was checking out because he was... Oh, Wayne killed that. He was so bad. I haven't listened to him in a long time. It's even worse. The auto-tune, then he was singing on with them. Like, and it was bad. You can't mix... The Weeknd, yeah, every artist uses auto-tune, but him naturally, if you listen to him, can actually sing. Lil Wayne can't sing without auto-tune, so it's just, whew. We need a version without Wayne. This is called, next track, Less Than Zero. I think we only have two tracks left. Yep. Less Than Zero, definitely pure pop heavy. Great track, definitely catchy. Love it. Lyrics was good, solid track. Definitely can listen to this. Definitely go on the playlist. Let's go to the last track. We are at the end of the album. Don FM. Overall, good. I gotta give it some more listens. I gotta listen to it again. Listen again. But I'm gonna put it. At the end, this is next track. Phantom Regret by Jim. Jim Carrey, I'm pretty sure, has been doing some of the narration of it, so I'm pretty sure this is him, The Weeknd, I don't know.
You're tuned to Dawn FM, the middle of nowhere on your dial. So sit back and unpack. You may be here a while. Now that all future plans have been postponed, and it's time to look back on the things you thought you owned, just did you take to your grave? When you weren't liked or followed, how did you behave? On when your body's long gone, and your phantom regret hasn't let it go yet.
Dawn FM. Finished it. Phantom Regret. That was more so like an epilogue. This whole thing has kind of been like a story, basically. It's all been like listening to a podcast, like a radio podcast. I guess that's the overall theme, besides love and heartbreak, as well as regret. Like this, the ending track kind of sums up the whole album, but it's more so like there's a whole bunch of messages in this album. But basically telling you to enjoy life, I think, as well as you gotta love, sometimes you gotta let go of love. But overall, if I have to rank all seven albums, Trilogy and Kissland are gonna be tied. And then I'll put Beauty Behind the Madness, then After Hours, and then I would put My Dear Melancholy. No. Starboy, My Dear Melancholy. I think I will put this again. I probably would. This isn't bad. It's not a bad album. Maybe I have to listen again and I'll give you another rank, but this is probably... I like all of The Weeknd's music, I do, but this is probably like at the low end, kind of. Or, you know, I'll put Starboy, then My Dear Melancholy. So, My Dear Melancholy, then this. So, this isn't bad. It's very different. I really, really enjoyed Take My Breath, Sacrifice, Out of Time, Here We Go Again, Is There Someone Else? That was probably one of my favorites. Besides Take My Breath, those two tied, and Sacrifice, Out of Time, great. I love Less Than Zero. I Heard You Married was good, but I don't take out Wayne. Starry Eyes was good. Best Friends was alright. I just didn't really like How Do I Make You Love Me and Gasoline much. And yeah, I can't really rank Phantom Regret or A Tale by Quincy or Dawn FM. Those are like, that's an intro, interlude, and then Phantom Regret is like the ending, like the end credits, the epilogue, whatever. So, guys, that was my reaction to Dawn FM, the seventh album. Well, six, really. Trilogy doesn't count, apparently, because it's just a all the mixtapes into one album. But this is the sixth album by The Weeknd, and that was my reaction. Those are my thoughts and opinions. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed it, please check out my other content. Check out my brother's content as well. Links down below, all my social media. Like the video, share it. I hope you guys listen to this album. Tell me your thoughts. Please comment down below and tell me what you think of it. I'm gonna have to listen to it again, really, like, kind of think about it. But overall, I liked it, but it's definitely at the bottom of all the Weeknd's album. It's nothing bad. It's just some of the tracks on there, I'm like, I don't know. But yep, remember to stay mentally fit, emotionally fit, physically fit. I'm out. Peace.